लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ. आई एम डॉक्टर प्रकाश साउंके, वर्किंग एज एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ वाल्सन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी सोलापुर. टुडे इन कंटिन्यूशन विथ आवर मेट्रोलॉजी सीरीज वी शैल बी डिस्कसिंग मैकेनिकल कंपैरेटर्स. इन मैकेनिकल कंपैरेटर्स टुडे वी शैल बी डिस्कसिंग सिग्मा कंपैरेटर. So students will be able to explain principle, construction and working of sigma comparator and will describe merits and demerits of sigma comparator as well as mechanical comparators. Sigma comparator. Every comparator is a precision instrument used to compare the dimensions of given component with the standard and measure the deviation from the standard. Sigma comparator is one of the mechanical comparator and consists of dial and pointer as a display unit. The displacement is sensed through a plunger or stylus. So if we refer figure 1, say you will find, yes, this is the sigma comparator. So this is the dial and pointers, that is a display unit, and say this is the stylus or plunger. The mechanism which is used for magnification is placed in a metal casing, normally of a circular shape, and sigma comparator is mounted on some stand or suitable base. So you can see this. So this is the metal casing inside which, say, there will be the mechanism, and say this is mounted on some kind of stand, So this is how the outward appearance of sigma comparator. Now let us try to understand the construction of sigma comparator. So let us see what are the different components. So one of the important component is the plunger. It is a cylindrical spindle which is in direct contact with the workpiece, and it is a notch at its center. So if we see the figure of mechanism of sigma comparator, you will see, so this is the plunger, so it is a cylindrical one, that is the sensing element. Now after the plunger, say there is a slit diaphragm. It consists of two flat steel springs and they hold a plunger in place. So they also act as a spring. So let us see their functioning later on. Then one more important element is knife edge. It is mounted at the notch of the plunger and transmits the motion of a plunger. Again, if we see the figure of mechanism, you will see this is the knife edge. So this is the notch in the plunger, and say this is mounted, placed in the notch. Now this knife edge, say it bears on the moving block. So bears upon the moving block. So moving block, so it is in direct contact of the knife edge. And this moving block is a part of cross strip hinge. If we see the figure, so this is the moving block. This is the moving block, and this knife edge is resting upon this particular moving block. And this is the cross strip hinge, as you can see. So this is a cross. So these are the four pieces. Cross strip hinge, it consists of four flat steel springs arranged at right angles and having a pivot at the center. Pivot is very efficient and sensitive to small angular motion. So if we see here, so this is the central pivot and this is the cross strip hinge. So one end is this moving block, another is the fixed block. And say this pivot is very sensitive, so it can sense the same in motion, and these three hinges, so they will be same in moving with respect to each other. Now, one more important element is Y-shaped arm. So it is also called as a forked arm. So it is a light metal forked arm having a Y shape, which connects the cross strip to driving drum. If we see the mechanism, so here you can see, so this is the Y-shaped arm, forked arm, and it is on one end, it is connected to this cross strip hinge. As the cross strip hinge, say, moves, say, due to movement of this moving block, say, then that motion will be transmitted to, say, this Y-shaped. And, say, this Y-shape transmits the motion to this driving drum. So, we shall see again the working. Driving drum, it is a small drum which supports the spindle carrying a pointer. Then there is a metal ribbon. It is a thin phosphor bronze ribbon fastened at two ends of the forked arm and wrapped around a driving drum. So if we see the figure, you can see, so this is the phosphor bronze ribbon. And it is, I mean, connected at two ends of the forked arm, and it is wrapped around the driving drum. So that driving drum is pressed. So it is in, say, this phosphor bronze ribbon is in tension. Then pointer and scale. So these are the two parts. Now, let us try to understand the working of sigma comparator. The plunger is placed initially in direct contact with the standard. So normally that plunger, the stylus, so that end is touched to the standard, and then it is slightly loaded to move upward. So plunger is slightly loaded to move upward. So if we see here, so this plunger, so that will be slightly loaded in upward direction, so it will be pressed up in upward direction, so such that stand is adjusted. Now tell me why to do this initial loading of plunger. Can you tell? Yes, think. Yes, loading is done so that if any workpiece is of smaller dimension than the standard, the plunger has to move downwards from the zero position to sense the deviation. So if, say, it is not loaded, there will not be any scope to move the plunger in a downward direction when a smaller component is placed. So initially it is loaded upward, and at this position, zero setting of the scale is done. You understood why loading is to be done. Now the standard will be replaced by the workpiece, which is to be checked one by one. If there is deviation in the dimension of the workpiece, plunger will move vertically upward or downwards. Just see here. If when that piece is placed here, initially for standard, it is slightly loaded and adjusted to zero. Now, workpieces will be set there one by one. If the workpiece is of higher, larger dimension, then it will push the plunger upwards. If it is of smaller dimension, then due to this slit diaphragm, which acts as a spring, so that will push the plunger downwards. Initially, it is loaded, so there is scope for moving towards the downward direction. Okay, so this is how that deviation is sensed. Now this deviation, the motion of the plunger is transmitted to the knife edge, which in turn presses the moving block of cross strip hinge. So if we see, so this motion is transmitted to this knife edge, and this knife edge, if it is moving upwards, so this knife edge will move upwards or downwards, say that will press the moving block accordingly. This moving block, say, will transmit the motion to this cross strip hinge. Cross strip hinge will move around the pivot, and the motion will be passed to the Y-shaped arm, which will rotate the drum through a ribbon. So if we see here, say this motion will transmit to Y-shaped arm, and Y-shaped arm will now reciprocate like this, and say like this, and so that will rotate, say this particular phosphor bond ribbon move, and the ribbon will in turn move this particular driving drum. When the driving drum rotates, the spindle mounted on it, so that will also rotate, and say that motion will be transmitted to the pointer, so which will move on the scale. So magnification is obtained in two stages: ratio of effective length of Y arm L and distance of the knife edge from the point pivot A. So that provides the first stage of magnification, where second stage of magnification is due to ratio of length of pointer L and radius of driving drum R. So total magnification will be equal to L by A into small l by R. So magnification range is normally 300 to say 5000. I have taken references from textbook of meteorology by M. Mahajan, Dhanpat Rai and Company Private Limited. I am thankful to you, and I thank you also.